Welcome back! My name is Baller Scuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1982, and we are still in Miner 2049er. When we last left off, I made it to station number 6, the radioactive waste. Let's see if I can't accomplish more here today. I am hoping for the best, but this one looks rather difficult. Let's see what I can do. Is that a moving platform? It is. Alright, that helps at least a little bit. Now let's grab that. All the way to the edge there. Yeah, that's what I thought. Gotta do all the jumps very, very carefully. Oh, that is. I didn't anticipate it going that far over. I wasn't paying attention to it. All right, let's try this again. There we go. Then all the way to the edge. Make sure I get that. Nope. All right, I missed that one, so we're going to have to wait to come back for that one. Still missed it. Can't get the timing on that one at all. I want to go over to the left here. There we go. And jump from there. Climb up, get that, and then climb back down. As far as I can tell, this is the only way to do it. I want to get it out of the way early because this one looks like it could be the death of me many times. So I'm trying to get this one done early. Missed it. Missed it entirely. I think I have 2 lives. No. All right, so let's reload the save state and we'll try this again. We're just going to do this trial and error until we can get it because I don't feel like going through all the previous levels over and over and over again. I can make that, right? And then that? Nope! So we're figuring out all the jumps that I can do. There's a few that I thought I'd be able to do. Turns out I can't. But that's why I kind of, go a little fast early on, because I don't anticipate actually being able to clear it. Okay, to there. I can do that. Nope! Okay! We're gonna have to reload the save again. And we're going to sort this all out eventually. That is the plan. And I've already screwed up. Like, I need that candle in order to jump from there, so. It feels less like a platformer to me and more just like a series of buttons that I have to press in a row. Really. So things aren't going well so far. Hopefully they get better. I didn't anticipate this game taking nearly as long as it did. We're still going. Who knows what the rest of the stations have in store for us. But there we go. Okay, we'll go over here. We never did figure out this jump, so I'm looking forward to actually accomplishing this one. If memory serves me right, I was a little early before. So we're gonna want to wait a little bit there. Still early. Still early. Yeah, this is just gonna be a series of me trying to get things done. I refuse to do a save state in the middle of a level. Although it probably feels like I should. If it gets to that, I will start doing that, but I would rather be able to accomplish an entire level on a single go. If I can. Okay, jump from there. And we'll have to figure out this one. The problem is that I still haven't quite figured out his jump length. And then, of course, the timing of it does change. There. Okay, there we go. Then up here. Over here. Then to there. All the way over. There we go. All the way there. Can I just drop down from here? Yes. That was scary. Okay, all the way to there. And then we'll jump back. Okay. Where do I go from here? Oh, I have to go onto that platform, don't I? I have to go on the moving platform. Do I? Is that death to do that? Let's try dropping to this one here. Okay. Then from there to here. Okay. This is looking good so far. Then jump from like here. That's too far of a jump. I thought I was doing so well. Let's get that to actually work properly here. There we go. Okay, we'll try that again. I was doing well. Solved a lot of the mechanics. But there's still more for me to figure out. There's kind of always more for me to figure out. I'll just take care of this. No! You have to be on the edge. You have to be on the very edge. It's going too fast. Tony Bob has a very specific jump. He goes full force, no matter what. Okay, so that's one of the scarier parts. Once again, I have to not trust my instincts and have to let it go a little bit further than I think. There. There we go. Okay, to there. And back. Up there. Very edge. Not very edge. Drop. There we go. Okay, then drop to here, and then to here. That wasn't what I wanted to do that at that point. That wasn't what I wanted. Okay. Then up. Down there. That. Timing on that is so difficult. So I think if I land on this. Yeah, there we go. Just had to do it quickly. Then up here. Okay, so let's go for this one. And then drop down from here. Over here. All the way to the edge. Now, how do I get... Okay. There we go! We got it done! Alright, Station 7, I have spawned. There are more transporters here. Let me go ahead and drop a save, because we're going to need that. Alright, Station 7, Advanced Transporters. This round has got it all! Transporters, slides, and moving pieces make this station one to remember. 7 possessions worth 2,300 points will help you munch up the 4 deadly mutants. Get the BF at the top to rack up big points. Is there anything else that we need to describe here? Nope. It'll be next level that we have to describe something else. Okay. Let's hope for the best. Let's see what I can do here. Did one just spawn behind me? And I only have 1 life. Super. Okay. So... Yeah, one spawns right there. Okay. How do I even start this one? I have to get on the platform to start. And once again, one just spawns. Yeah, I can't get the timing of that. Let's just go to 4. Okay. And then we'll eat you too. On this little moving platform where this is... And that is death. Okay. Yeah, he spawns right there. Okay. 4. Let's just... Oh, immediately. Immediately dropped. Okay, let's get these guys. Nope. No? Well, okay, I got that one. Can I even make it up to this from where I am? I don't think so. I don't think I can do that. So how do I get to that one? Okay, jumping up from here. Oh, that does take me up there. Okay. To this. Nope, missed the timing on it. A little early. All right, go straight over to 4. Don't get dropped yet. So my dog shakes. Okay. There we go. I'm like, why aren't we dropping? Okay, then there to there. We'll grab that. Eat both of you. Okay. Onto this, then onto that. To the highest spot right there, which puts me there. I meant to jump to the left, but he didn't want to go left. He wanted to go straight up. Okay. We'll start at 4 again. Oh. Well, we'll start at, like, dropping all the way. Okay, let's go. And once again, I can't quite make that. But I can. Nope. Can't get the timing right on that. Like I said, it's very specific. And because I have no control once he's in the air, it's just all about timing. There we go. Then we'll take that to 3. I felt like I timed that right. I felt like I had that one. I still like transporting to 4 to start, but sometimes it takes me down, sometimes it doesn't. Go over and eat these guys. Saves me the hassle. Because I haven't figured out how to get anything else so I can eat them. To start, the guys at the bottom. Okay. Just a hair light. Let's try it again. Okay. Start, like, further to the right. That is a trick. And then just, yeah, we'll drop. Over and eat these two. It's easy to get off the moving platforms. It's getting on them that's difficult. Okay, then we can take the warp up to 3. I'm not sure this is the right path, but it's the one that makes the most sense to me right now. Nope, too far. Too far! I wanted to avoid it. Ugh. I'm not even, like I said, I'm not even sure that's the right way to go. But I think starting here on 4 is the right way. I need to be over to the right more. That way I can get all of that. Drop down there. Grab that. Come over. Meet both of you. Once again, can I? No. Alright, salvage that somehow. Take that up to 3. No, I didn't mean to drop down again. Okay. On the right side. Somehow that counted. All right, that's fully done. Come over and eat these two. There we go. Up this up to 3. No, that was too early. Try it again. On the right side. Yeah, the hat doesn't have to be in the transporter. No! That's not what I meant to do. Oh well. It's not like I'm gonna beat this one anyway. Not on this run. I still have much more testing I need to do. Nope. Okay. So I haven't figured out how to get to that platform. Too late. The timing's just so particular. Maybe we'll try doing this. No, because then that guy's gonna be in the way. No, he's not. Okay. Okay, so that's all cleared. Let's take the right one. Nope, missed it. I can grab that, but I still don't know how to make that platform over there. I would have to stop somehow on that right platform. Like, with all these slides, it gets... It's so particular on how I have to do it. Okay. And over there. Over here. Hop onto that. Nope. Alright, well then forget it. I didn't want to go on that platform anyway. Come over and eat you too. Alright, let's do that. Nope. Alright, so this one's proving to be very difficult for me. So I'm probably going to... Let's see, what do I want to do here? I'm probably going to save a second... like hard save here, and I'm going to start doing things inside the level, doing saves inside the level. Not necessarily what I want, but you know, this one's taking far too long and I feel like it's not working out well, so we'll take care of this as best as I can. over here, then jump there. There we go. Somehow this does not hit me. I'll take it. Okay, now if I go down this left one and I hold like any given direction, it doesn't matter. It just slides all the way down. And up here. Okay, so let's pause and I'm gonna drop a save here because this is starting to get to me. Okay. And up here, over here. Nope. All right. Well, that's why we do that. Okay. Let's just get through this. I do have to jump to the right. Or sorry, to the left there. And up. That was my opportunity to eat that guy, wasn't it? Because I don't have anything else that I can really eat to get him. So this is why we do things like this. And why I don't save too often. Because I can easily screw myself up if I'm not seeing the patterns that I need to take right away. Okay, so then we'll go up to 3 and I will drop another save here. Okay. Nope, not good enough. Okay, so that one's not the one that I actually... What am I doing? This isn't the one that I actually need to rush on. It is this one. And that's how you get all of that, and then... You can drop down from there. So all of the enemies are gone. But... Nope. How do I get past all of that? Okay, so... Nope. Even once I've cleared all the enemies, that doesn't necessarily mean I can win. No, how do I get over to that side? I might have to be done on a second run here. Okay, so there. Okay, that time I got it. Let's drop another save here, because we got through what we needed to get through. Question is, now what? And then over there. Good. There. How do I make this? How do I get to there? That's how. Okay. Okay, that does count for what I wanted to. But now the question is still this one. How do I get that? I don't think warping's necessarily going to help me, but we'll try again. Let's go to 3. And then, once again, I have to just kind of avoid all of this. 1,100 points for the record. And then we'll drop down here. No, we have to go to the... We were there. We were close. How? What? I jumped straight into the slide there. That is not what I wanted to do. Okay. Yeah, down here. Once again, straight into the slide. That's not what I'm trying to do. I think you know that game. There we go. There we go. Try to be extra cautious. Can I make the jump over to the left from here? Yes. Yeah. Okay. And it counts. Okay. Okay. We'll grab that. Just let me on this thing. There. Let's try jumping to the right. That's how you do it. Okay. And there we go. We got through it. That took way too long. All right, station 8. Oh boy. Let's drop another hard save here. Oh, this does not look good for me. And we'll drop the quick save as well. Okay, station 8, the lift. Jump onto the lift to hoist Bounty Bob to anywhere in the station you want. 5 mutant aliens guard the station, but getting the 6 possessions totaling 1500 points can help you to extinguish them. Alright, so there's a new description here for the lift. This device is essential to completion of the station. To activate the lift, you first must jump onto it. Now press the space bar on the keyboard. As the whir of the engines start up, you are now under lift control. Push the joystick in any direction, and the lift will move accordingly. Press either the red joystick or the space bar to cancel lift control. Note the lift will move slow going upward because Bounty Bob is such a fatso. Hint, you must put the lift all the way up before you can climb the ladder in the center. Okay, that sounds terrible. Let's get back in and see what we can do. I don't know what that line is at the bottom, but oh, well, it's instant death, whatever that is. All right, well, I have to be like all the way over here. Spacebar. Now under lift control. Okay, canceling lift. There we go. Oh, that's not bad. What? So that's a point of no return. That has to be where I have to be at the end. All right, so let's see what I can do without the lift first. That's a broken ladder. Okay, so we're learning things. That's kind of the way that this game works is, all right, let's see what I have to do here. No point in climbing that as far as I can tell. Control the lift. I'm gonna go over here. But now I can't get, like, the lift back. Yeah, how do I get back on the lift? I'm not sure I see how to do this one just yet. Because there's two spots that I can't seemingly come back from. There's got to be a way for me to come back from that left one, but this right one, I don't see how. Just go ahead and grab that. Why not? Give me the points. Okay, so if I go this way, go all the way like that, can I make that jump back? Well, it would help if I actually jumped. Too busy trying to get onto the edge to actually try to make that work. All right. Come on. There we go. Alright, all the way over to the left there. Okay, I can make that. Let's kind of go up to this next level here. Wait for you to... Didn't anticipate that one up there. Didn't anticipate that one at all. Okay. Far right there. Sorry, far left there. Try to take care of you. Then we can take this lift up. Wait for you both to go away. Jump over you. No, there we go. There we go. Okay. Activate the lift. Come up here. Control the lift again. This time we made it here. Wait for you to go away. There we go. Try to be safe about it. Don't hit my head on an enemy. Okay. Screw it. I'm dropping the save state here since I've already done it. I feel like it's... We're past that. We've breached it. Yeah, there's no way for me to do that, is there? Okay, we'll try this again. Try doing, you know, something else entirely, basically. Oh geez, time's running out too. Can I make this jump? I can. Oh, jeez. No! Alright, hold on. We have to figure this out a little bit better. Quick load. Okay. So from here, I need to first go over here. We gotta be pretty fast about this. Alright, can I drop down? That's death! No, I have to start from the beginning! Alright, that's why we have two. Let's start this over. Alright, so when I climb up here at the beginning, I need to go over there and grab that. Okay. That's the first step. Right, I do need to be over here. Grab that. What? That's not what I wanted to do at all. Okay, so we're gonna have to drop more saves here. Okay, so there. There. And back down. Let's pause and drop a quick one here. That's the first stage down. Then climb up, grab that, go down, hit the button, jump over here, get you. And jump back. Okay, let's pause. That's stage two down. All right. There we go. There we go, just take care of you at once. Alright, let's drop a save here. Okay. Back in. Wait for you. No! You went further than I thought. Alright, this is why we do stupid things like this. Right there. There we go. Okay. You. Nope. Alright. Ugh. How dare you? I refuse to let you die. Alright, through there. Wait for you guys to go away. There we go. You don't go that far. You take that down, take this down. There we go. All right, and we pause again. Let's drop several saves here. Save state hard. Oh, and I can always reload. This one is a quick one. All right. Station 9, the Pulverizers. Another tough station for Bounty Bob to finish. Step up to one of the parked moving pieces and start it moving to the other side. But watch out for the slide that stands between you and the platforms that you have to make it to. Go down the slide to the bottom and prepare to walk around this station. But there are also 8 possessions, adding up to 1,600 points for you to use against them. Yeah, there's no additional thing here. All right, so the pulverizers, those are going to be fun. Okay, so what I need to do is clearly take this top one over first. There's one down. Oh, nope. Slide. I do survive, but that's not fun at all. Can I jump past that? Oh, I have to jump off of them right off the bat. That's not fun. Okay. How is that what I asked you to do? How is that what I asked you to do, Bob? I need you to listen. Right away. Okay, so is it random? I was trying to figure out the timing for him. Seemed like it just waited for me. Okay. Go up. I'm gonna go ahead and drop a save here. We got one pass done. Yeah, there's no time for me to like back off of that. To jump past it. As long as I wait for the right time, I think we'll be alright here. Still gonna drop a save though. Just in case. I think I got it, but you know. They could do something stupid. Crazy. What? Or I could be stupid and crazy. Not what I anticipated doing. That wasn't what I wanted to do at all. But I got both of them. So we're possibly okay here. Okay. I'm calling that a victory so far. Even if I have to take my time here. There does seem to be a pattern to them. Okay, another save. Once again, I don't care about points. That's not what I'm here for. I'm here for completion. If that means I miss a couple of the items, I'm okay with that. All right, last one. Save. Let's not screw this up. And go, Bob. Too early. Go, Bob. There we go. Station 10. This does not look good, does it? Okay. Hard save. And quick save. Alright, so, Station 10, the cannon. Go into the TNT hut and load the cannon with as much TNT as you need to shoot yourself to any level of the station you want. 6 aliens await you on this station. With no possessions but the TNT to get, munching the aliens is impossible. One last warning, do not overload the cannon. So we can't actually eat the aliens. Have they always been called aliens from the beginning? There were organisms in Station 1, organisms in Station 2, organisms. I'm looking through the manual here, like, when did it change? Okay, so Station 1 through 6, they're organisms. Station 7, they're mutants. And then 8, they're mutant alien guards. In 9, they're aliens. And in 10, they are aliens. So we went from organisms to mutants to mutant aliens to aliens. All right, so we need a little bit of a little teaser here for the cannon. A little bit of instructions. The cannon. In this station, the only way to get to the top is by blasting yourself out a cannon. Jeez, is this safe? Firing the cannon is a simple matter. First, you must load the cannon with enough TNT to get you to the level you want. Do this by going into the TNT hut and touching the TNT canisters that you want loaded into the cannon. Each canister is equal to 10 tons of TNT. You need 10 tons for each level you wish to be shot to. Example, to reach level 3, load the cannon with 30 tons or 3 canisters. The digital TNT indicator at the top will tell you how much TNT has already been loaded. Once the cannon is loaded, climb the ladder and walk off the left of the framework to fall into the cannon. Now push the joystick right or left to aim the cannon. Press the red button and pow, you're on your way up. Warning, don't overload the cannon or the explosion could be fatal. All right, so they told me twice not to do that. Let me do another quick save here. The first thing that I'm going to do is what they told me not to do. That sounds like a plan to me. Oh, that's what's stopping me there. Yep, danger. That's what I want to see. So, obviously I'm going to die here. But I want to see what happens. Okay. There. And go. What do I do? I thought it was press the space bar. The red button. I mean, not entirely what I expected, but I'm glad that I tried it. Okay, so I don't know how I want to start this. They say I don't have time to get over there and eat them, and they are right. Okay, up. There we go. No! I tried. I tried. Not enough time. Alright, let's grab one of these. One of these threes. I feel like that's probably for, you know, better. It's better for me to get that instead of trying to get all the small ones right off the bat. Okay, so, like I said, there's no way for me to really eat these guys. But I can jump over them still. Okay, I have to wait for my right opportunity though. No, it's still, I thought we would be fine there. I had to wait for the one on the first level to move, but then the one on the third level got me. Alright, so let's try to get one of these again. We're not going to get there in time to eat anybody, but that's okay. Still like going this way. Have to wait for you, though. There we go. Let's actually avoid this altogether and try to go to the other side. Can I make it to the other side? I think that's a gap too far. Okay, there. Another one of these threes. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and drop a quick save here. Seems like a good spot for it. And there. Trying to find a good spot to drop. There's always somebody there. There. Okay. Jeez. Okay, we'll get one of the twos, because I think I'm done with the threes. And we'll try to go to the right side. I like the right side better. We'll drop another quick save and see what I can do here. Alright, so far so good. Once again, I'm assuming that I can't make that jump over, but I might as well give it a shot. So let's pause, and we will do a quick save, and we'll just test this here. Nope. No can do. I didn't think so. It's not too surprising to me. Alright, we'll grab another two. Drop here, and we'll make sure I don't screw this up again. Just launch from there, we'll be good. Alright. Safe enough. Let's get this level one. This is where things might actually start getting difficult. That left side is not going to be fun for this. Alright, so let's drop a save here. See if we can't get this done. This is the one that scares me the most. No problem. All right, we got through that. I'm running out of time, though. Even with all my cheating, I'm running out of time. I don't... It might have saved in a bad spot for me here. I don't have time to go back and get it. I don't have time. I have to actually start over here. Okay, so let's rush this a bit then. Time limit's much harder than I thought. All right, we're gonna grab... Well, I can't grab all of those, can I? No, that would be very bad. Okay, so I need to grab just one. So I need to clear all these very quickly. Go. Quick save there. Nope. I'm in a rush now. So I'm gonna make mistakes. There you go. Nope, not fast enough. Nope, can't jump over him that way. Now all of a sudden I'm playing sloppy because I need to rush a bit. That timer goes down pretty quick. Nope. We'll get this, though. It's gonna take a bit of time, but we will finish this thing. This is the last level, after all. Alright, wait for you there. Okay. Trying to go quick here. Pause. I gotta pause every time now. Okay, save there. Launch there. And drop. Okay, that was very quick. That worked out very nicely for me. I gotta save all the extras for last. Who knew that time was going to be my biggest problem here? Alright, so then we'll drop the save here. Wait for those to go away. Launch and go. Get out of my way. There. Okay, that wasn't necessarily the fastest, but I think I have a little bit of room here. Okay, we will save here. And go. I feel like I didn't, like, lollygag or anything like that last time. They just don't want to give me a whole bunch of time. I still have two of these to go. Alright, so then we'll drop a quick save there. Wait for you. Once again, this is the scariest part for me. Okay, that was fairly quick. Drop a save here. I can fire right away, though. Alright, and then drop down. We got all that stuff there, so let's just clear all this out. And we have plenty of time. Plenty. Come on. We're in danger, but I'm not shooting anymore, so it's fine. And we've won! And what do we get for all of that? We get to go to Station 1 again, but this time at Zone 2. This is basically the same thing, but harder. It just kind of cycled around, so... if you were actually hoping for some resolution with Yukon Johan or any of that, you're not going to get it. I already forgot about that jump. But there we go. Game over. Minor One has died. We'll put in our name. There we go. There's my high score. Thanks to cheating. Now, what you can do from this screen is you can actually start on higher difficulty. So if I wanted to, I could do, I don't know, 7. And here you can see everything is moving so much faster. But you still have to do everything from the beginning. You can't start at a certain station. You can just start at the higher difficulties. So this is something that is available if it's something that interests you to try to do this on higher difficulties where the monsters, the enemies basically, whatever you want to call them, mutants, aliens, organisms, whatever you want to call them, they move around much more quickly. Yeah, I wasn't really trying. If you want to do that, that is a possibility for you. You know, we'll just go ahead and hit enter there. I don't care. But that is Miner 2049er. With the game now played, let's talk about how the game holds up today. Playing the game today, I do have to say that it is enjoyable. There is some enjoyment that you can have playing this game, but it does feel like a prototype for what we would call the platform genre. It feels like it's not necessarily all the way where it needs to be. There's still some control issues that I have, some issues when it comes to judging heights. There's a lot of memorization that happens with this game. There's a lot of trying to figure out where your hitbox is, what falls you can survive, what jumps you can make. But the fact that there are 10 screens is huge. So if you can make it through all 10 screens, it will help. But that first time that you make it through all 10s of those screens, there's a lot of guess and check. There's a lot of memorization going on. But there is some enjoyment to be had with this game. The gameplay is, I would say, the best part of the game, especially the depth of the gameplay, the fact that you can play for 10 screens. With that said, I do enjoy the plot as well. I'm always a big fan of the plot, but it felt like the plot was just kind of thrown on there. And if it wasn't added in, I'm not sure it necessarily detracts from the game. The game doesn't necessarily feel like it's... When you play the game, it doesn't feel like you're actually accomplishing the plot. It doesn't feel like you're finding Yukon Johan. It just feels like you're going through a mine, making sure you step on every single spot, and you avoid enemies. That's pretty much it. The rest of it is just kind of fluff. It's fluff that I typically enjoy, but it didn't necessarily feel like I was doing that in the game. In terms of graphics, I have to say that the graphics are fairly good. They're not necessarily standouts for 1982. Even on computers, I wouldn't necessarily say that the sprites stand out a little bit more than everything else. In terms of sound, I would say that it's not particularly good. The shuffle sound effect that you get for Bounty Bob can get a little grating after a bit. I tried not to point that out while I was playing, but it can. The fact that you die so often also, that sound effect also starts to grate on me. But that's more because I feel like I failed more than anything else. It sounds more like an explosion than Bounty Bob melting, which is what I assume happens. I'm not entirely sure, to be honest, but he just kind of collapses into nothingness when he dies. But overall, I think the game is fun. It's definitely a game that is worth visiting if you are a fan of platformers and you want to see how that started, how the platform game started, then it's definitely worth visiting for people that are kind of interested in the overall history of video games. This might be something that is better watched than played, but it's definitely something worth talking about. So I'm happy that I went through and I played it. It definitely was a lot harder than I thought it was going to be. I figured that I could get through this in about a half hour, and that did not happen. But a lot of that has to do with me not having the game memorized, not having the jump pattern memorized, not knowing every jump and every pattern that I have to take in order to beat the level. And that's what beating this game requires. So the game is fun. Like I said, it's not the best platform game. I'm still calling them platform games if I can remember. The platform game genre does evolve quite a bit over the next couple years. So we will see much better platform games come along fairly quickly. So that's why this kind of feels like a prototype. But this is definitely a game that was very good for its time. I just don't think it's necessarily aged that well. So from a modern perspective, because there are so many platform games that followed it, this one is easily going to be forgotten in my mind, and it's not necessarily worth going too far out of your way to explore this one, but this was huge at the time, and I think it's worth revisiting just for that. But with, you know, a little asterisk of play as far as you can. Don't necessarily try to get through all 10 stages like I did. I did it because I wanted to show it off, but it's something that you can watch if you don't necessarily have the skill or patience to make it through all 10 levels. And that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, Miner 2049er proved to be popular among the critics. In particular, the critics enjoyed the design of the game as well as the scope. It proved to be popular among the audience as well, with readers of several magazines voting it among their favorite games of the time. As time has gone on, however, the game has seemed to be forgotten, and the game's reputation at the time seems to have disappeared. Nevertheless, the game was popular enough to warrant ports to several different platforms. Work would also begin on a sequel. We will keep an eye on these as we continue. Looking ahead, despite the success of Miner 2049er, Big Five Software struggled to match their previous success on the TRS-80. We will hear from the company one more time in the future. That will also mark the last time we hear from Bill Hoag, the developer of the game. While Bill would continue to work in the industry, he would never reach the same success again. That will do it for the story of Miner 2049er for now. My name is Baller Scuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we get beamed inside.